we just took an initial look at how we can use aria roles and properties to specify the semantics for a particular element. However, we should remember that native HTML elements have implicit semantics. For example, input type equals checkbox implicitly has a role of checkbox. This means two things. Firstly, there is usually no need to redefine default semantics. An input type equals checkbox does not need an extra role equals checkbox attribute to be announced as a checkbox. We'll come to an exception to this rule later on. Secondly, certain HTML elements have restrictions on what aria role and attribute values may be used effectively on them. Most of the time, unless you're doing something pretty weird, you won't run into any issues, but the aria in HTML spec has a table explaining what aria may and may not be used with each type of HTML element in case you want to get creative. For example, a text field, input type equals text, may not have a role attribute applied. Speaking of implicit semantics, we mentioned earlier that HTML landmark elements may be used to help assistive technology users find their way around the page. Aria also offers a set of landmark and document structure roles. Many of these are redundant with HTML5 semantic elements, but depending on what browser versions you need to support, it may be necessary in some cases to use both an HTML5 semantic element and a redundant aria role. For example, main role equals main. Breaking the general rule of not redefining default semantics because the default semantics may not be fully supported in this case.